In this video, I wanted to take you through setting up the voltage monitor first level protection and for the DJI Naza controller using the Naza Assistant software. So before we get started, let's go ahead and take a measurement. I have a fully charged Lipo 3S, and this will tell us the voltage for each cell as well as the total voltage. So we have 4.2, 4.23, and 4.18 for a total of 12.7 volts. And let me mention that my quadcopter has four 950 kV motors, four 30 amp ESCs, the DJI F450 frame, as well as the Naza, and obviously the 2.2 amp 3S LiPo battery. The weight is roughly 2.29 pounds, which comes to about 1.04 kilograms. Okay, after you hook up your Naza, we'll go ahead and click on your voltage monitor tab, and let's turn on the protection switch. And the first thing we want to do is do a battery calibration. So I'll go ahead and kick that process off. Current voltage is 12.7, 12.8, it fluctuates a little bit, and that's pretty close to almost identical to the reading we took with my voltage meter. So calibration is successful. Okay, let's start with the first level protection. What the DJI Naza documentation recommends is setting the no load voltage to 1 volt less than your current voltage. So we'll go ahead and set that to, we'll just say 11.6 volts. And what we want to do is we want to acquire through a test flight, essentially the line loss voltage. So what we'll do is we'll start by setting the loss at 0 volts. We'll fly the quad until the first level protection is triggered by the blinking red LED, and then we'll take another voltage reading and we'll measure the difference between the new voltage and the no load voltage, and that will essentially be the line loss. So I'm going to go ahead and write these settings, and then we'll do a test flight and calculate our loss. So this is sort of a test run for me, but hopefully we can see, you'll be able to see how stable the Naza is in this video, but we'll take off from the ping pong table and I'll kind of hover and move around and try to keep the battery monitor, the voltage monitor, in view. So let's give this a go. So right now we're at 11.9 volts, and we'll trigger at 11.6, so let's keep it going. Okay, there we go. See the red VU blinking? We'll go ahead and land. So we triggered the first level protection. I've hooked the Naza back up, and you'll notice the current voltage is 12.1 volts. So originally we had our no load set at 11.6. And the LED first level protection We saw that go off. So what we need to do is take the current voltage, subtract what we put in for no load originally, which if you remember was 1 volt less than what the full battery charge was, which was 12.6 volts. So now we're at 12.1 minus 11.6, and that puts us at a loss of half a volt. If you look at the Naza documentation, which I have right here, it does mention that if the line loss voltage of a battery is over 0.3 volts per cell, depending on how many cells you have, so in a 3S battery case, that's 0.9 volts, they suggest replacing the battery. So just something to keep in mind. Okay, so the million-dollar question is, what do we put in for the no load voltage value now that we found that the loss is half a volt? And so, you know, you can read around in the forums. I've kind of done my own very limited research, but let me show you kind of what I'm thinking. So I mentioned before this is a 2200 milliamp battery, and the quad itself weighs about 2.3 pounds. And so if you look at this chart of just some basic hovering and moving around, let me get to the chart. And I'll actually make this document public for those who want to take a look at my values. So at a full charge, we're at 12.6 volts, the 0 minute mark, obviously. And then over time, you can kind of see, obviously, the LiPo, the cell voltages drop. And really where it gets interesting is between the 9 and 9 minute and 40 second mark. So that at the 9 minute mark, we're looking at about 10.8 volts. So what I'm going to do for my first level protection voltage is set that at about 10.5 volts. And that 10.5 volts comes to about 3.5 volts per cell on a 3S LiPo. So that's what I do for the first level protection. Do some of your own experimentation on this, but my rule of thumb is about 3.5 volts per cell, a 10.5 volt no load total, which as we see with the loss, it's 10 volts loaded. So that some may consider that fairly conservative, but you know, it's one of those situations where you rather be safe than potentially lose a quad. As always, don't forget to write these values to your Naza controller. Next up, I'll post a video on the second level protection where we ignore the LED warning, we keep the quad in the air, and we can watch, hopefully, the second level protection kick in, safeguard, and then the quad will automatically descend and land. So feel free to post any questions, and like I said, I'll share that Google document for those who are interested, and you can take a look at those data points. Thanks for watching.